In this example, we are given that a spherical hollow cavity is made in lead sphere of radius r and such that its surface touches the outside surface of lead sphere. That means here the cavity radius is r by 2 and we are required to find the gravitational field strength at a point P as shown here, and mass of sphere before the cavity was made was m. So, in this situation, we can simply write that now gravitational field at point P is equals to gravitational field due to complete sphere minus gravitational field due to mass of cavity. As the mass of cavity is removed, we can directly state whatever gravitational field was there at point P due to the mass within this cavity, that will now be subtracted from the whole gravitational field due to the sphere. And in this situation, if we substitute the value of gravitational field due to sphere at point P, that can directly be written as gm by d square, that is the expression for the gravity due to a point mass, minus we find out the gravitational field due to the mass of cavity. If we just have a look on the volume of cavity, we can see the cavity radius is r by 2. That means if we talk about its volume, it is 4 by 3 pi r by 2 whole cube. So this will be 1/8 of that of the complete sphere. And as mass is uniformly distributed in its volume, we can simply state that the mass which was enclosed within this region would be m by 8, as its volume is 1/8 of the total volume. So, at point P, the gravitational field due to this m by 8 mass can be written as g m by 8 by distance square, and this distance y we can write as simply d minus r by 2. So, this will be d minus r by 2 whole square. And if we just simplify this expression, here this d can be taken out and gravitational field at point P can be written as gm by d square, and it is 1 minus 1 by 8, 1 minus r by 2d whole square. This will be the answer to this problem. That is the gravitational field at point P due to the sphere with a cavity of radius r by 2.